Hello and welcome to another episode of Today's GK. I am Pooja Divedi, and in this segment, we bring to you objective questions on a daily basis to help you with the preparation of the prelims exam. So first, let's have a look on the practice question of last segment. Consider the following statements with reference to special assistance to states for capital expenditure scheme. All the states of India except Tamil Nadu have availed benefits under this scheme. Second, capital expenditure has a higher multiplier effect, enhancing the future productive capacity of the economy and results in a higher rate of economic growth. So, it was announced by the Finance Minister as a part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. Which of the statements given above is are correct? A2 only, B 1 and 2 only, C 2 and 3 only, and D 1, 2 and 3. I hope you have answered it correctly in the comment segment. The correct answer for this question is D, that is 1, 2 and 3. All the statements are correct. So special assistance to states for capital expenditure scheme means that all the states except Tamil Nadu have availed benefits of the newly announced scheme for special assistance to states for capital expenditure. And this scheme was announced by the Finance Minister on 12th October as a part of the Atmanirbhar Bharat package. Also, the scheme is aimed at boosting capital expenditure by the state governments who are facing a difficult financial environment this year due to the shortfall in tax revenue arising from the COVID-19 pandemic. Capital expenditure has a higher multiplier effect, enhancing the future productive capacity of the economy and results in higher rate of economic growth. So as we all know that due to the imposition of COVID-induced lockdown, the trade was impacted negatively, and because of that, the GST revenue collections couldn't be done properly, and that is the reason the scheme has been initiated by the central government. Moving on. Therefore, despite the adverse financial position of the central government, it was decided to extend a special assistance to the state governments in the respect of capital expenditure in 2020 to 2021 in order to bring the economy back on track. Let's move on to the first question for today's segment. You have to match the martial arts from the state it belongs to. Mukna from Madhya Pradesh, Gatka from Punjab, and Mardani Khel from Maharashtra. So which of the pairs given above is or are correctly matched? A1 only, B 1 and 2 only, C 2 and 3 only, or D 1, 2 and 3? Think it through, please. So I hope you have answered it correctly. The correct answer for this question is C, that is 2 and 3 only. Now, if we talk about it, then Mukna belongs to Manipur, Gatka belongs to Punjab, and Mardani Khel belongs to Maharashtra. In addition to it, I would like to tell you that there is one sort of martial art which is the oldest in India by the name of Kalaripayattu, and it belongs to Kerala. It is the oldest form and it originated in the 4th century AD. Then we will talk about one more, Thangta. Thangta belongs to Manipur, and if we talk about Thoda, Thoda belongs to Himachal Pradesh. So you have to remember it that it's Kalaripayattu, and that is the oldest form of martial arts in India. Let's move on. Which of the following states are covered under the 6th schedule of the Constitution? Assam, Meghalaya, Nagaland, or Manipur? You have to select the correct answer using code given below. 1 and 2 only, 2 and 3 only, 1, 3 and 4 only, or 1, 2 and 4 only. The correct answer for this question is A, that is 1 and 2 only. That means Assam and Meghalaya are covered by the 6th schedule of the Constitution. This particular schedule of the Constitution, which deals with Articles 244 Clause 2, and 275 Clause 1, provides for decentralized self-governance and dispute resolution through local customary laws in parts of Northeast, which are mainly tribal areas. And it is the part, it belongs to part 10. Remember this as well. Because sometimes what happens in the exam, the schedule might not be asked, and to confuse the students, the part may be asked. So you have to remember that it belongs to part 10. And schedule 5 of the constitutions deals with the tribal areas which do not belong to schedule 6. The list of the states that are in schedule 6 are not dealt with schedule 5, right? It contains provision as to the administration of these areas, of tribal areas, in the states of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. So, before that, I would like to tell you that who is empowered to declare an area as scheduled area? It's the President of India, right? Now, I would also like to tell you that there are certain reasons, there are certain necessities for an area to be described or declared as a scheduled area. First, there should be majority of the tribal population there. So, in that particular place, tribal population should be there in majority. Second, there should be a compact region or reasonable area, and it should be of like district, taluka or a block, right? And the third thing is that it should have the feature of being economically backward. Economic backwardness with respect to the neighboring areas, right? These three criteria should be fulfilled. And there is one more criteria, the fourth one, you should comment in the comment segment. So let's move on. Project 17A, recently seen in the news, is related to which of the following? A. National Supercomputing Mission, B. Stealth Frigates, C. Artificial Intelligence, and D. Golden Quadrilateral. The correct answer for this question is, first you must think through. Project 17A. It belongs to B, that is Stealth Frigates. So, Project 17A Frigates, it is a design derivative of the Shivalik class stealth frigates. Construction of P-17 or Project 17A ships differ in the very concept of warship building by way of adoption of the modern technology, integrated construction, where the blocks are pre-outfitted before joining to reduce the build period of warship. And Project 17A class frigates are being built using indigenously developed steel and fitted with weapons and sensors along with integrated platform management system. Three ships are having stealth frigates, stealth, any military technology intended to make vehicles or missiles nearly invisible to the enemy radar or other electronic detection. That is why it is known as stealth. So, before that, I would like to tell you that there is also one very famous project by the name of Project 75, and it deals with the Indian Navy as well, and this particular project is related to submarines. Okay, moving on. On which of the following river Polavaram project is located? Mahanadi, Kaveri, Krishna or Godavari? Think it through. The correct answer for this question is D. That is the Godavari River. Moving on, Polavaram project is an under construction multi-purpose irrigation project, and it was conceived in the year, it was conceived in the century, in fact, 19th century, under Sir Arthur Cotton, and it was a part of the National River Interlinking Project. It was a part of the National River Interlinking Project under the supervision of Sir Arthur Cotton, and it was conceived in the 19th century. Okay, so if we talk about the features, it envisages construction of earth cum rock fill dam across River Godavari. The maximum height of the dam is 48 meters. It is being constructed on the Godavari River in the West Godavari District and East Godavari District in Andhra Pradesh. Its reservoir spreads into parts of Chhattisgarh and Odisha states also. And it was also declared as a national project in the year 2014. Moving on. In the year 2014, the Government of India declared the project as a national project. The Polavaram Project Authority was constituted by the Union Cabinet in May 2014. If we talk about the significance for Andhra Pradesh, it will irrigate nearly 3 lakh hectare of land, generate hydel power with installed capacity of 960 megawatt and provide drinking water facilities to 540 en route villages covering 25 lakh population. But there are certain other problems which are related to this particular project. The most significant of that is rehabilitation of the people who are living in the surrounding villages. And it was actually a bone of contention between the people and the government. So, moving on. In which one of the following groups are all the four country members are belonging to the G7? Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Australia, Canada, Italy, USA, Brazil, France, Saudi Arabia, and Vietnam, and Canada, Japan, Singapore, and South Korea, belonging to G7. The correct answer for this question is A, that is Canada, France, Germany, and Italy. Moving on, the G7 or the group of seven includes Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, the United Kingdom, and the United States. And it is an intergovernmental organization that was formed in 1975 by the top economies of the time as an informal forum to discuss pressing world issues. Initially, it was formed as an effort by the US and its allies to discuss economic issues. And can you please tell me in the comment section which of these countries are a part of the group of five, that is G5. Thank you. Moving on. The G7 forum now discusses several challenges such as oil price and many pressing issues such as financial crisis, terrorism, arms control and drug trafficking. It does not have a formal constitution or a fixed headquarters, and the decisions taken by leaders during annual summits are non-binding in nature. Canada joined the group in 1976 and the European Union began attending in 1977. The G7 became the G8 in 1997 when Russia was invited to join. However, in 2014, Russia was debarred after it took over Crimea. Moving on, which of the following statements is or are correct about members of Parliament's Local Area Development Scheme, that is MPLADS? Funds are released in the form of grants in aid directly to the district authorities. It is under the aegis of Ministry of Rural Development. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is A, that is 1 only. Moving on to the explanation, this particular scheme it is also known as Sansad Nidhi Yojana or Sansad Nidhi Yojana. It is a central sector scheme for MPs to recommend works of development nature in their constituency. Was launched in the month of December in the year 1993, and it emphasizes on creating durable community assets based on locally felt needs. And it is under the aegis of Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, that is MOSPI. The fund are rupees 5 crore per annum per MP. And under this scheme, this particular amount is non-lapsable in nature. Funds are released in the form of grants and aid directly to the district authorities. And MPs do not have a complete authority. They have only a recommendatory role. And the district authority is empowered to examine the eligibility of works, select the implementing agencies, and also monitor it. So be very careful with the last point. That is MP the absolute authority under the scheme? No. He or she just plays a recommendatory role, right? Moving on. Consider the following statements about the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana or PMJ. It offers a sum insured of Rs. 5 lakh per family for only secondary health care. The beneficiaries are identified by the latest socio-economic caste census or SECC data. Now, which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. Look at the statements once more. The correct answer for this question is B, that is 2 only. Moving on to the explanation. It offers a sum insured of Rs. 5 lakh per family for secondary care, which doesn't involve a super specialist, as well as tertiary care, which involves a super specialist. That means for secondary as well and for tertiary as well. And it is an entitlement-based scheme that targets the beneficiary as identified by the latest socio-economic caste census data, right? And also, the insurance cost, if we talk about, it is shared between the center and the state, and mostly the ratio is 60:40. The National Health Authority has been constituted as an autonomous entity under the Society Registration Act of 1860. Please keep this in mind, under which particular act it is registered. Okay, so Society's Registration Act of 1860 for effective implementation of PMJ in alliance with the state governments. Moving on, consider the following statements about Agricultural Produce Market Committee or APMC. It is the marketing board established by the state governments. It is responsible for the regulation of agricultural trading practices. Which of the statements given above is or are correct? A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, D neither 1 nor 2. The correct answer for this question is C, both 1 and 2. Both the statements are correct. So the APMC, it is a marketing board and it is established by the state governments. Keep this in mind. And under the APMC Act, states are geographically divided into markets, which are headed by market committees, and any production in that area shall be brought to a market committee for sale. Now, if we talk about the aim, its aim is to ensure farmers that farmers are safeguarded from exploitation by large retailers and are responsible for the regulation of agricultural trading practices. So if we talk about agriculture, it falls in the state list under the Schedule 7 of the Constitution. Okay, moving on. The APMC system was introduced to prevent distress sale by farmers to their creditors, to protect farmers from the exploitation of intermediaries and traders, to ensure better prices and timely payment for their production through the auction in the APMC area. So distress sale, like we have panic buying, then there is also a concept of distress sale when something should be sold off immediately because of some contingency or uncertainty or lack of security in the future, right? Moving on, which of the following countries are members of the Indian Ocean Commission? Comoros, Madagascar, India, Mauritius. You have to choose the correct answer using the codes given below. A, 1 and 2 only, B, 1, 2 and 3 only, C, 1, 2 and 4 only, or D, 2, 3 and 4 only. The correct answer for this question is C, that is 1, 2 and 4 only, Comoros, Madagascar and Mauritius. So if we look at the explanation, the Indian Ocean Commission is an intergovernmental body created in 1984 to protect the interest of the Western Indian Ocean Islands, and it consists of Madagascar, Comoros, La Réunion, which is the French overseas territory, Mauritius and Seychelles. Now Seychelles is also a very close friend of India, and India is the observer state of the Indian Ocean Commission. So India is not actually the part of this particular commission, but it has the observer state. And India should be very interested in this particular commission because of the rising Chinese offensive, not only in the territorial integrity, which doesn't not only affect the territorial integrity of India, but also the coastal integrity of India. Right? Moving on. Consider the following statements about great hornbill. Hornbills are found in temperate zone. It is listed as endangered on the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. The bird is the state bird of Kerala and Arunachal Pradesh. Select the correct answer using the code given below. A1 and 2 only, B2 and 3 only, C3 only, and D1, 2 and 3. The correct answer for this question is C, that is 3 only. Only the third statement is correct, that it is the state bird of Kerala and Arunachal Pradesh. So hornbills, these are found in tropical and subtropical Asia, Africa and Melanesia. The bird is closely identified with the social and cultural life of the Nagas as reflected in various tribal dances, songs and folklore. If we talk about the IUCN status, it's vulnerable, and this species was uplifted from near threatened to vulnerable in the year 2018. The Great Hornbill Festival that is celebrated was first ever celebrated in the year 2000. Now the Great Indian Hornbill is also known as the farmers of the forest or forest engineers, because they distribute seeds of the tropical regions, of the tropical trees. That is why they are known as farmers of the forest. Alright. Also, it is listed in Appendix 1 of the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species or Sites. And the bird is the state bird of Kerala as well as Arunachal Pradesh. Moving on, let's look at the practice question. Urban Governance Index of 2020 was recently released by A. Niti Aayog, B. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, C. Center for Public Policy Research, and D. Praja Foundation. So this particular index has been topped by Odisha in urban governance. This is the hint. So that's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Thank you so much for watching and stay updated.